every detail of your appearance, your state of health, and the slightest nuances of behavior, all this is programmed by DNA and RNA molecules. This is what we were taught in biology class. However, everything turned out to be completely different than what we thought. Just recently, what we know about genetics and heredity has been turned completely upside down. So, what else besides DNA is capable of encoding genetic information? And how will a new discovery help to overcome incurable, dangerous diseases? And also, perhaps, find extraterrestrial life? In fact, DNA and RNA continue to be important genetic molecules. But far from the only molecules involved in genetic functions, DNA and RNA are nucleic acids and are composed of nucleotide residues. They're similar to the ones and zeros in computer code. Depending on their sequence and combination, the architecture and features of your entire body are encoded. Until recently, scientists knew about only two types of such nucleic acids. But many researchers wondered if there could be many more. To find out, chemists from Emory University, Tokyo Institute of Technology, and the German Aerospace Center in Cologne used a computer program called MolGen 5.0, designed to calculate the potential number of different molecular structures. Then they determined the composition and structure of a molecule capable of storing genetic information. In such molecules, there must be a part that other molecules recognize as encrypted data. In the case of DNA, this role is played by the following four components: adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymine. Given that, the other molecules should also have similar substances capable of successfully connecting into one structure. After that, the researchers ran all the data through the pipeline pilot program, which simulates the molecular formulas based on the entered indicators. The results were more than impressive. The program found about 1,160,990 types of molecules that meet all of the necessary criteria. The only difference between the molecules obtained and DNA is the absence of characteristic carbohydrates and phosphorus atoms. Otherwise, especially in functionality, the new molecules are very similar to DNA. This discovery has raised a host of other questions. Among the huge variety of living organisms on planet Earth, and more than 1 million similar molecules, why have DNA and RNA become the main programmers of life? Even though these two molecules are very close to each other, they're far from equal in their abilities. Their only differences at the chemical level are a matter of a few small details. RNA has one more oxygen and carbon atom and one less hydrogen atom, which makes it quite vulnerable. RNA molecules dissolve in water 100 times faster than DNA. In addition, DNA has a double strand. Well, RNA has only one. So, the DNA bases are placed inside the spiral and protected from harmful effects. DNA replication is one of the most basic processes that occur within a cell. Each time a cell divides, the two resulting daughter cells must contain exactly the same genetic information, or DNA, as the parent cell. To accomplish this, each strand of existing DNA acts as a template for replication. This process is completely impossible in the case of RNA. Nevertheless, as many scientists believe, it was RNA that became the first molecule to encode the genetic information of life, but then lost the lead in the evolutionary race to DNA molecules. Obviously, the same thing happened with all the other similar genetic molecules. Under terrestrial conditions, they couldn't remain competitive. But even if they couldn't compete on Earth, it's likely that they managed to do so on other planets. Scientists suggest that the discovered molecules could be carriers of genetic information about alien life. This is just speculation, but it will allow us to predict the features of extraterrestrial beings even before we can find them. In addition, this new discovery will allow humanity to one day, forever, overcome viral diseases from which hundreds of thousands of people die every year. The fact is that these dangerous life forms use nucleic acids to copy their genetic material. In other words, to reproduce. Since their genome is small enough, they don't require identical nucleic acids, so even slightly different ones will do. The work of most modern antiviral drugs is based on this vulnerability of viruses. They consist of nucleotide analogs of DNA that can degrade the viral genome, preventing it from multiplying. Since scientists have managed to discover more than a million similar molecules, doctors will now be able to develop a cure for every viral disease considered so far incurable. The same goes for cancer. Cancer cells often mutate and copy DNA in an unusual way, making treatment difficult. Here is the cancer cell gene. The large X-shaped elements are chromosomes. DNA in the chromosomes is wound on tight coils, like a thread, which guarantees that only some genes will become active, while the rest won't show themselves, but will remain in a dormant state. However, next to the large chromosomes, you may notice some small circles, which represent the greatest danger. This is the so-called extrachromosomal DNA. Its genes are 3 to 5 times more active, which allows cancer cells to grow much more aggressively in a victim's body. If synthetic molecules imitating nucleic acids, which will destroy the DNA of cancer cells, are added next to the tumor, this will help completely cure this dangerous ailment. In turn, by using a certain variation from a million molecules, it will be possible to create a separate medicine for each and every type of cancer. Another area of human life where you can apply a million DNA variants is data storage. Scientists have already managed to put information on DNA. For example, in 2017, researchers from Harvard were able to encode the first moving picture in the history of mankind, created back in 1878, on the DNA of Escherichia coli. Genetic material is denser than modern storage media. The genome of one bacterium has storage volume density of about 10 quintillion bits. That's 10 to the power of 19 per cubic centimeter, or 0.06 cubic inches. This means that the entire amount of information necessary for all of humanity could be placed in a cube of DNA, the size of which would be equal to 3.28 feet, or 1 meter. In addition, the lifespan of conventional digital media is quite short. For example, an average hard drive is capable of performing its functions for about 28 years, while the half-life of DNA is 521 years. For the data recorded on genetic material to completely disappear, it would take more than 1,000 years. Considering that there are more than a million potential varieties of DNA-like molecules, they could completely replace digital media. In fact, scientists from the University of Maynooth and the California Institute of Technology have already managed to create a semblance of DNA-based software. At first, scientists used the DNA origami technique to fold a long DNA sequence into a specific shape. Then the researchers developed 355 DNA fragments and, using computational algorithms, combined them with the previously obtained forms. During the execution of various algorithms, DNA fragments could determine the parity of numbers and even count to 63. Simply put, scientists created a primitive living computer system created exclusively from DNA molecules. Thus, today, DNA is a kind of analog to Homo sapiens among genetic molecules. Of the many species of man, only our species survived. Out of 1,160,990 theoretically possible nucleic acid compounds, DNA has come forward and monopolized its right to be the hard drive for all life on the planet. A different combination of only four DNA elements managed to create a huge variety of life, from bacteria to dinosaurs and humans. But if other genetic molecules had won the evolutionary race, what form would modern life have taken? Write your opinions on this in the comments below. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already done so. And click on the bell to receive timely notifications of new and fascinating, interesting videos that are waiting for you ahead.